Excel has a function called COUNTA, and we are looking at a worksheet called COUNTA. There is a companion function called COUNT, very similar in nature with one obvious difference. First of all, when you click a column letter, or if you highlight cells, you are likely to see in the status bar at the bottom of the screen a count and also a numerical count. In column C, there are 100 cells that have data in them. There are 99 cells that have a number in them. And so by deduction, of course, you can see we are talking about the differences there is heading in column C. Now in column D, we have got some blanks there. But as we click column D, look at the bottom of the screen. 93 of those cells have data in them. 91 have numbers. There is a difference of 2. Might not be obvious what's going on there. Now the function called COUNTA actually tabulates the number of cells that have data. For example, equal COUNTA, and we can look at any column that we choose. For example, column B. How many of those cells have data? 100 of them. I will click over in column B. Double click the bottom edge down to row 100. All of those cells have data in them. How many of them have numbers? That is going to be, I will simply copy this and then drop the A there. And we are expecting to see 99. Now highlighting column B again, going to the bottom of the screen, there we see the word count, meaning cells that have content. So there is a little bit of confusion here. The function called count counts numerical cells, but the status bar entry at the bottom of the screen counts the cells that have data. So recognize that potential confusion there. Click in column B again. Numerical count is analogous to the function called count. Count is analogous to the function called count A. And so we see the difference here. Now going back to column D for the moment, and I will just adjust this for the moment to be D. 91 cells have numbers, equal count A in column D. 93 of these cells have content. So why the difference? A sharp-eyed observer will pick this up. This is not a 1, looks like a 1 at first. There appear to be no other 1s in these numbers over here. That's a little unusual. Typically, there probably would be. So down here is a 1. And you can see the obvious difference. So that's an L. Or is it a capital I? We don't know necessarily. So as I zoom in, just recognize that from time to time, here is what lowercase l looks like. And as I hold down shift, here is capital I. And here is a 1. And it's pretty obvious. The 1 looks different. But if you have zoomed way back, and if you are looking at lots of data and you are not sensitive to that concept, at times you will see bad data with a capital I or lowercase l, and they could be confused with a 1. And at other times, possibly you will have the 0 difference. Here is a 0. Here is a capital O, looking very similar except when they are nearby. All the data over in column C has zeros that are accurate and have capital O's over there. But going back to this basic idea, remember, count A counts the number of cells within a range that actually have data. Count counts the cells that have numbers. And again, there is that potential confusion as we look in the status bar. I will click column D here for the moment. Count down here counts the number of cells and actually have data. But the function called count counts the cells that have numbers. They are both really valuable functions, and I think you will see lots of uses for them. COUNTA and COUNT.